واشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم For many weeks we went through a galti ka azala because I wanted to answer the claims of the Rabwa Jamaat or Qadiani Jamaat that in that Hazrat Sahab had changed his claim from that of a Mujaddid to that of a Prophet. Another point of disagreement of or difference between the Lahori MDs and the Qadiani MDs is this question of Khilafat. And you often hear Qadiani saying that, you know, we have the Khalifa and that is why we've done this and we've done that and so on. So I thought it would be useful to go through this question in the next few weeks. Now, Khalifa obviously is the word of Arabic language. So we have to see what it means. Literally, you can say that Khalifa means a successor. But the question then arises, a successor to whom and in what sense? And the misfortune of the Ahmadi Jamaat is that a large part of it has been led astray because they pick one meaning of a word and they apply it in all contexts. And as I showed you with the use of the words Nabi and Rasul, that you have to see the context in which a word is used before you can say what it means and what its significance is. Now, we have the famous verse in the Holy Quran where God says to the angels, this is about creation, and God says to the angels, what am I going to do? That I am going to place a Khalifa or my Khalifa on this earth. This is chapter 2, verse 30. Here, the word Khalifa is used usually to mean a ruler. God says to the angels, I am going to place in earth a ruler. So the word is Khalifa. So someone who rules can be a Khalifa. A Khalifa doesn't have to be a prophet only. A Khalifa can be a prophet, but he can also hold temporal authority. He can be a king, as Hazrat Dawood was, as Hazrat Suleiman was, Solomon and David. They were both prophets and they were also rulers. They were kings. And the Holy Quran again refers to this when it says that speaking to David, God says, O David, I made you a ruler in the land. I made you a Khalifa in the land. This is in chapter 38, verse 26. So the question then is, are all Khalifas like Hazrat Dawood and Hazrat Suleiman or Hazrat Adam? Well, obviously not. For example, in the famous ayat istikhlaf, as it's called, which is verse 24, which is chapter 24, verse 55 of the Holy Quran, that God promises Muslims, God promises the Holy Prophet, that there will be Khalifas after him. There will be his successors. But then, interestingly, God also refers to other people as Khalifas, such as people of Makkah. Now about David and Solomon and so on, you could say that they are prophets, they are believers, and God uses the word Khalifa for them. But people of Makkah before or at the time of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were not believers. They worshipped idols. And yet God still used the same word for them. And he said, addressing the people of Makkah, he said, and he, this is Allah, and Allah makes you successors, khulafa, in the earth. So they were rulers, they ruled that town, and they were also called khalifas. So non-Muslims, non-believers, this term is used for them. So we have, after the Holy Prophet Muhammad, we have Khulafa'i Rashideen, or the rightly guarded Khalifas, or the righteous Khalifas, which is Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Usman, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhum. But after that, you had a hereditary kingship. First of Bani Umayya, in English they are called Umayyads, and then following that of Bani Abbas, who are called Abbasids. But they also use the word Khalifa for themselves. Now on the one hand you have Hazrat Abu Bakr, who is a Khalifa, whose door was always open, who slept on a rough bed, who gave in his will instructions that any money that he had taken from the public treasury for his own expenses should be returned to it by selling his personal property. So you have that Khalifa, and you have something like Harun Rashid or Mamun Rashid or Mutasib Billah. They were also Khalifas who lived in great palaces. People were barred from entering those palaces, and they had all kinds of comforts and power and wealth and so on and so forth, whereas other people didn't. So would you then say that Harun Rashid or Mamun Rashid or all these others, Walid and so on, who used the title Khalifa, they were Khalifa in the same sense, with the same rank as was Hazrat Abu Bakr and Hazrat Umar and Hazrat Usman and Hazrat Ali? No, of course you wouldn't. Because Khilafat is spiritual as well as temporal. You can have rulers who are called Khalifas like Dawud and Solomon, and like Hazrat Abu Bakr, Umar, Usman and Ali, and you can have Khalifas who are Khalifas of Awliya, of saints. And as we know, there are four sort of sections which are famous. There are Naqshbandis, Chishtis, Qadris and so on. These are all silsilas. These are chains or organizations of Sufis who follow one saint or another. And each saint, when he passed on, after him was appointed a Khalifa for spiritual guidance of the people who were left behind. And of course, you have Khilafat in the sense in which Hazrat Sahib said that the Anjuman that he created is his Khalifa. So the Anjuman is Hazrat Sahib's successor. And lastly, of course, you have Khilafat in the sense in which Mia Mishiridun Mahmud Ahmad Sahib said Khilafat existed. And he especially compared Khilafat to papacy. He said that Muslims destroyed Khilafat within a few years, and he said that the true Khilafat would resemble that the way the Pope works, which actually meant was that the Khalifa or the head is above making any mistake. He cannot make a mistake. He cannot commit a sin. He cannot commit an error. And he has to be obeyed unquestioningly. So these are about 8 different contexts in which the word Khalifa is used. What we have to decide is, in what sense was Khilafat created in the Jamaat-e-Ahmadiyya, if it was ever created, and whether Hazrat Sahib intended there to be an autocratic dictator who was to be obeyed at all times, at all costs. So more on that later.